I ran for the state Senate because, like so many of you, I was frustrated. From high taxes to overregulation of our businesses, the laundry list of challenges that our state faces is great, but not as great as our determination to overcome them. It was clear from the governor's address today that economic growth and development will be a priority going forward this legislative session, and I look forward to working with the executive to make sure that tone goes beyond rhetoric to become a reality. However, to be frank, the proposal doesn't go far enough to address the economic challenges facing middle-class taxpayers, and it certainly doesn't go far enough to help the private sector create the new jobs we need to ensure that our young people can build their lives in New York. As a mom, that's especially important to me. Come April 1st, the enacted budget needs to control spending while giving a boost to our hardworking taxpayers. It should encourage private sector job growth by reducing the cost of doing business in New York. And we need to cut onerous regulations that stifle real growth and development. We need to provide a high-quality education for every student in our area so that our young people are well prepared to take the jobs that our businesses will create. To do that, we need to eliminate what's left of the gap elimination adjustment scheme that has done serious damage to our schools. The enacted budget needs to make investments in infrastructure, and I will fight to ensure that money from the state's major settlements makes its way to our local communities. It is time to make New York a place where people want to live, not one they want to leave. The residents of the 41st District can rest assured that I will consider the governor's proposal carefully and with that specific goal in mind.